وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جزاكم الله خيرا. So, سورة النساء. This is the second longest surah in the Quran after Surah Al-Baqarah. It's longer than Surah Ali Imran. And one of the most wonderful surahs in the Quran. Surah An-Nisa includes 5 ayat. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud saying, I prefer to have it more than the entire dunya. What are these 5 ayat in Surah An-Nisa? Amazing 5 ayat, all in Raja. إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرُ مَا تُنَهَوْنَ عَنْهُ نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَنُدْخِلْكُمْ مُدْخَلًا كَرِيمًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. The one that we recited, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ولو أنهم إن ظلموا أنفسهم
جاءوك فاستغفروا الله
ثم جاءوك فاستغفروا الله واستغفر الله الرسول لوجدوا الله توابا رحيما. من يعمل سوءا Okay, it will come in our recitation. These 5 ayat all in رجاء, very high hoping in Allah's mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was mentioning that this ayat, subhanallah, he would never prefer the entire dunya more than having this 5 ayat. So, Surah An-Nisa, if we want to say one topic for this surah, what is the topic of Surah An-Nisa? And why it's coming after Surah Al-Baqarah and Al Imran? We mentioned Surah Al-Baqarah for the entire Islam, for the deen, for building up the deen. Surah Ali Imran, the defending, how to defend the deen from the disbelievers, from the attacks, from the doubts and the wars, the physical war by sword from the mushrikeen, included Ghazwat Badr, and how it was full of ayat for the believers and giving the perfect example like Ali Imran, how to sacrifice for the deen to protect this deen from being demolished and damaged. Then Surah An-Nisa is coming to mention that after you build the deen and after you have the protection, the external protection from the external enemies, now there is something very, very important. Factors demolishing the deen from the internal society. So Surah An-Nisa was speaking entirely about rights, حقوق. A lot of rights in this surah. And mentioning how to protect the society from inside. And mentioning a lot of jahiliyyah was happening at that time, especially against the weak ones, before they try to think a lot. شوف الأول والثالث تعالي. Okay, so a lot of jahiliyyah was happening before Islam came, especially against women. They were taking the money of women. If her husband died, they will not give her portion from wealth. If she is young and her uncle is taking care of her, raising up this girl until it reached the adult age, he would marry her with very low mahr or without mahr. A lot of oppression was happening to women. That's why in the beginning of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what? Before وآتوا النساء صدقاء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا ها وآتوا اليتامى أموالهم orphans. Allah started by orphans. Most of the orphans they were oppressed in jahiliya. The person in charge who is raising up these orphans will take money for himself and saying I am taking care of them so I have portion from this money. That's why Allah said if you are poor take small amount which is sufficient for you to survive. And if you are rich, you cannot take from their money. Orphans, weak. No one to protect them in these wild societies. Islam came to give the perfect right before all this, you know, human rights, women rights, all rights. And at the end you see, innocents are killed daily, by thousands, and we don't see any rights. And they will never reach the perfect level of rights unless they follow Islam. Definitely, Islam is coming from the Creator. That's the perfect rights. So orphans and women. The ayah after the ayatul yatama walahum wa la tabaddalu khabitha bil tayyib wa la ta'kulu amwalahum ila amwalikum innahu kana huban ay ithman kabira. Wa atun innahu kana huban kabira. ولا تأكل أموال اليتامى إنه كان حوبا كبيرا. Where is حفار؟ Then before. فانكحوا ما طاب لكم من النساء مثنى وثلاثة وربع. This before, right? So Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned this ayah. Some people are thinking, what is the relation between اليتامى, the orphans, and getting more wives, second and third and fourth wife? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said you can have two, three, four wives? In the same ayah is telling you be careful, I'm warning you from oppressing the orphan, because they were taking these girls, orphans, raising up them in their homes. They reach, you know, the 12 years old, whatever, they marry them and they don't give them their financial right. So Allah told them, don't do this. If you want to get married, you have outside a lot of women. You can get second and third and fourth marriage. But don't oppress this girl. Give her her full right. Then Allah spoke about mahr. Because also in Jahiliyyah, you know, they were making it as business. And I'm sorry to say, till now, in some countries, they're making business by marrying their girls. His daughter is asking a huge mahr from the groom or the person who wants to get married to his daughter, and he takes this money for himself. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. It happens. Wallahi, it happens till now. This is the money of whom? Of the woman. If she wants to give her husband in future, it's up to her. If she doesn't want to give, it's up to her. That's why Allah said, فَإِنْ طِبْنَ لَكُمْ عَنْ شَيْءٍ مِّنْهُ. If they gave you with pleasant soul, they are pleased to give you this money, فَكُلُوهُ هَنِيئًا مَّرِيئًا. You can take it. Otherwise, it's haram. And then you will find al-mawarith. Al-mawarith is coming in the Quran in details. You know, mawarith, inheritance. That when someone is dying, when someone dies, then how to distribute his wealth. Inheritance, ilm al-mawarith, is coming, this very detailed knowledge, very detailed subject. Allah mentioned in the Quran mostly the general things in the deen, the big issues, the big matters. Mawarith, it should come in the sunnah. It came in the Quran, in three ayat, all the knowledge of mawarith, in a miraculous way. But still, why Allah mentioned? To close the door for any differences in opinions. It's very big matter, and they used to have a lot of dhulm till now in Upper Egypt, in some places. Till now, in some places of Muslim countries, they have great dhulm towards women in distributing the wealth. Especially, you know, brothers and sisters. You'll find one brother or two brothers, they took the best land. And they give the sisters, oh, it's small, small area like this. Or they will take all. We will take care of this. Later, later, we will give you. And they don't give. You are married to some rich husband. Why to give you? We are men. We have to spend. We will take this money. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Dhulm, jahiliyyah against women. This destroys Islam more than fighting by swords with the enemies. More than rockets and bombs. Society is destroyed. Dhulm, jahiliyyah, darkness. That's why you will find a lot of rights. If you go every page, you will have rights, rights, rights. Rights for women, for orphans, and rights for men also. That's why when Allah mentioned a lot of rights for women, maybe the men were afraid, well, what is for us? That's why Allah said what? الرِّجَالُ قَوَّمُونَ عَلِ النِّسَاءِ بِمَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ وَبِمَا أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. Indeed, men, they have قوامة. What is قوامة? Who knows? قوامة. What does it mean, الرِّجَالُ قَوَّمُونَ?
No.
This is later, yeah, Kareem, you will know, inshallah. Huh? Not power. Okay, one opinion, authority, or power. I will not mention the name because maybe as family it will be a problem. So, saying power or authority, is it true?
Huh?
What do you think? Qawama is responsibility. They have the responsibility, the leadership of the family. Leadership. And of course, it includes some meanings from authority and power, and of course. But the main meaning or the real meaning of qawama is what? Responsibility and leadership of the family. It is in the hand of whom? Of the man. That's why he is responsible to get the expenses. To get cover the expenses of the whole family, even for his wife, even she is rich, right? الرجال قوامون على النساء. So the men, they have the responsibility, they have the authority within their family. It's for men. And Allah said, بما فضل الله بعضهم على بعض. That is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this preference for the mankind over womankind in this responsibility and authority. وَبِمَا أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. And because of what they are spending from their money. Then again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning about if two, husband and wife, they have conflict, or the wife become nashiz, she is disobedient. What to do? Three levels by sequence. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, if they obeyed you, فَإِنْ أَطَعْنَكُمْ فَلَا تَبْغُوا. Don't oppress. خلاص, they obeyed. Why you still oppress? Why are you still abandoning her? She returned back to you. She is now obedient to you. فَلَا تَبْغُوا عَلَيْنَا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيًّا كَبِيرًا. He is the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ali is like in the highest and has the power over you. He's above you. And he is the biggest. Kabira. So don't think, you know, some men think inside their house, I can do anything. Allah is above you. They can do more than you. Right? So that's why Surah An-Nisa, you go through after that, you will find a lot of rights. From that, Allah mentioned, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ. Obey Allah. وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. And obey الرَّسُولَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. Why Allah did not say وَأَطِيعُوا أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ? Why? Why Allah said obey Allah, obey الرسول and أُولِي الْأَمْرِ? Okay, what is أُولِي الْأَمْرِ? Maybe you don't know أُولِي الْأَمْرِ.
Righteous.
Who is أُولِي الْأَمْرِ? Righteous scholar, okay, that's correct. But not only.
Ruler.
Ruler?
Righteous.
Okay.
Khalifa.
Okay. الأولو الأمر العلماء والأمراء. As Imam al-Bukhari and many other scholars, they mention that that is the correct opinion. Ulul Amr, the rulers and the scholars. The rulers who are ruling the Islamic states and the scholars, the Islamic scholars. Okay. But why Allah did not say and obey Ulul Amr? Because it is not always. It is related to the previous order. If they are ordering us, the rulers or the scholars, with what is matching the orders of Allah and Rasul, alayhi salatu wasalam, then we obey. And if they are ordering us with something is opposing or against the orders of Allah or the orders of Rasul, alayhi salatu wasalam, we don't obey. لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. No obedience for a creature if it is disobeying the creator. And then you will find from the things which is destroying also the societies, the Muslim society, is what? When we have different opinions, what to do? أَلَمْ تَرَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ يُرِيدُونَ أَنْ يَتَحَكَّمُوا إِلَى الطَّاغُوتِ. Haven't you seen, O Muhammad, those who claim they believed in you, in what was revealed for you and what was revealed before you, they want to have judgment for Taghut, Shaitan, for Jahiliyyah. You tell them, now, if we have different opinions, let's go to the Quran and Sunnah. Okay, you don't have access to the Quran and Sunnah. Let's go to the scholars. Ask their opinion, ask their fatwa. Let them solve between us. And we follow, we say, سمعنا وأطعنا. Say, no, I will go to the Japanese court. I will go to the blah blah, this jahiliyyah, I will apply it between me and you. Come on, brother. You want to go to Taghut? يريدون يتحاكموا إلى الطاغوت وقد أمروا أن يكفروا به. And they were ordered to disbelieve in this Taghut, in this jahiliyyah. This is not from the truth, this falsehood. It's batil. Of course, in some cases, the Muslim may go to some courts in the non-Muslim countries in very specific cases. This is another issue, another fatwa. I'm speaking in general now. So, subhanallah al-azim, when two have conflict, and then you bring the Quran and Sunnah, and you'll find some people say what? Sami'na wa ata'na. And some people say, Sami'na wa asayna. Wal'a'adhu billah. That's why Allah mentioned. After that, وإذا قيل لهم تعالوا إلى ما أنزل الله وإلى الرسول رأيت المنافقين. وقف وقف جميل. If you tell them, come to what Allah is revealed to the Quran, come to the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, you will see the منافقين. Now they will appear. Because before that, you know, as long as everything we are just praying together, you cannot distinguish. But when you will distinguish, when there is conflict, and you tell them, now we will apply the Quran on every person, the Sunnah on every person, you will see the munafiqeen, they will turn away and they will not accept. رأيت المنافقين يصدون عنك صدودا. فكيف إذا جمعناهم الآيات. Then Allah said, فلا وربك لا يؤمنون. Indeed, by your Lord, Allah is making an oath, they will never believe until حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم. Until they will make you, O Muhammad, the judge for what they have dispute between themselves. ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم. Only they accept the judgment from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. No. And also they will not find within themselves, within their hearts, any dissatisfaction, any displeasant feelings. ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت. ويسلم تسليما and total submission for the judgment of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. That is the real believer. Other than that, not real believer. Maybe Muslim, but not a believer. Check ourselves now. Check, look, you see how many person in the Muslim Ummah is not listening to scholars at all. How many Muslim in the entire Ummah is saying, why I need scholars? I don't need scholars. MashaAllah. Amazing. And some, they will follow the bad scholars to take the fatwa according to their bad passions to please themselves. They will search more and more on Google until they will find any scholar in the world. He mentioned this is halal. Ah, halal. خلاص. حبيبي, this fatwa is not fatwa. And this person, you know, who is this person? This is how we are very far from the truth. It's a very important point. That's why Allah revealed a lot of ayat about it. How are you solving your problems with your wife, with your children, with your neighbors, relatives, friends, society, in the company, in the business? How? According to what? According to what? Those who are cheating and deceiving, say, I'm deceiving kafir, no problem. He's kafir, no problem, brother. Let's take their money. Is it okay? In Surah An-Nisa, Allah revealed ayat against one Muslim who oppressed Yahudi. La ilaha illallah. Muslim against Yahudi. The Muslim thought, if I go to Rasulullah, definitely Rasulullah will give me priority and he will judge for me. If I go to Abu Bakr and Umar, definitely I will be in their side, definitely. I am Muslim and this is Yahudi. No, they were Yahud at that time were living as citizens. They have rights. When they went to the Prophet ﷺ, this Muslim did not accept the judgment of the Prophet ﷺ because it was for the Yahudi. So he went to Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr said the same judgment the Prophet ﷺ gave. It was in the preference of Yahudi because he was on the right side. Muslim was oppressor. Come on, you are oppressor. Even you are saying la ilaha illallah, but you are oppressing this person. They went to Umar. Umar said, you went to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and you didn't accept his judgment, and you went to Abu Bakr, you didn't accept? One moment. He went to bring his sword. Really, he went to bring his sword and he was going to kill him. It's munafiq. What is this? Allah revealed ayat in the Quran to give the innocence of a Yahudi over a Muslim. Imagine how the justice of Islam, how just is Islam. Allah is the all just, no oppression. You know, some people come to masjid, you find them, mashallah, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. You go to deal with them in business, astaghfirullah, this is like kafir. This is not a Muslim. Lying, deceiving, cheating, going, let's a'udhu billah. And making money from deceiving and lying, it's haram money. Because you are deceiving people, you are earning haram. And growing your body from haram, your family from haram, what do you expect? Surah An-Nisa rights, justice. And it doesn't matter, even if you are not a Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you your right in this dunya. Go to Jannah or Nar in the Akhirah, this is a different matter. So the entire surah was to fix the society from inside, the internal society, to avoid being demolished from inside yourself. And the most important factor, or let's say the most important element in the society, is women. Why? Some people think women are half the society, even though now they exceeded 50%, I guess. In Japan, maybe they are 55 or something like this. I don't know exactly, but they are more than 50. But let's say women are 50%. Are they 50% in their effectiveness? No. Women are 100%. Women, if she is righteous, she will fix her children. And if she had righteous children, they will change a lot in the good way. Women, if she is righteous and she is obedient and she is good wife, she will have this influence on her husband. You know, the righteous women from the Salaf would tell the husband before going outside, earn halal money, never earn haram money. We can be patient for starving and hunger in this dunya, but we will not be patient for Jahannam and for the fire in the hereafter. This is the righteous woman. But nowadays, if someone will a'udhu billah, not righteous wife, you know what she will say? We are working only 8 hours and we don't have a lot of money. I cannot purchase what I want. I cannot buy what I want. Go and have double work, triple work. Work more. I don't care from where you bring. Take loan from the bank. I don't care about interest what you say, I just need money. Right? This happens, right? We hear these stories. Big difference, it will have influence on the husband, influence on her brother, on her children. Subhanallah, the women are so effective. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made one complete chapter, one complete surah about women, their rights in Islam, and how to change their status from very, very low in Jahiliyyah, how they were oppressed, until now in some countries. They're so oppressed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the best ever status in life by being Muslims. And that's why all over the world, you will find a lot of converters to Islam from women, because they find the safety in Islam, the rights in Islam, justice in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to be all justice people. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to be fulfilling the rights of others. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from oppression and dhulm. Ameen. Alhamdulillah.